This is a short video to help you memorize the branches of the maxillary artery. The maxillary artery is the bigger branch of the two terminal branches of the external carotid artery. It has three parts depending on the relation with the lateral pterygoid muscle. Here we can see the lateral pterygoid muscle. So this is the lateral pterygoid muscle, and we can also see it in this illustration right here. The parts are the mandibular, the pterygoid, and the pterygopalatine parts. This is the maxillary artery, and we can see the illustration by the color. The mandibular part is posterior to the lateral pterygoid muscle. The pterygoid part is adjacent, and the pterygopalatine part is anteromedial. It enters the pterygopalatine fossa through the pterygomaxillary fissure. Even though we have a lot of branches, don't worry about it. An easy way to memorize the branches of each part would be to memorize the following sentence. Damn, I broke my pretty doll. I put super glue, please don't approach. Let's see what it means. The mandibular part has the damn I. So what each and every single letter means is D for deep auricula, A for anterior tympanic, M for middle meningeal and its branch, the accessory meningeal, I for inferior alveolar and its branch, mental. Pterygoid stands for broke my pretty doll, which is the buccal, the mesenteric, the pterygoid, and the deep temporal. So BMPD, BMPD. The pterygopalatine part has the I put super glue, please don't approach. So I stands for infraorbital, P stands for posterior superior alveolar, S stands for sphenopalatine, P stands for pharyngeal, D stands for descending palatine, and A stands for the artery of the pterygoid canal.